Let's discuss the origin of magnetism. So first of all, before we move ahead towards the origin of magnetism, we all know magnetism is a property of material that responds obviously at atomic or subatomic level to applied magnetic field, right? So this is something which we know very well. Now let's understand how this magnetism comes into picture so far as the materials are concerned. So we all know, let's get back to the theory of, you know, circulating charges in an atom. Electron, they move in circular orbits around the nucleus. You can have a look at this picture. Okay, now when they move in circular orbits, they also spin. So they are performing two types of motion. One is the orbital motion, or you also call it as revolution. And the other one is the spin motion, or you also call it as rotation. So these circulating electrons, they will behave like a ring of wire carrying current. So the moment they behave like a ring of wire, you know, carrying current, it's going to introduce magnetic field around it. That's how. So we will talk about how the magnetism comes into picture out of that magnetic field. So please make a note of this before we move ahead. Yeah, so I believe you have noted this down. So as I have said, the electron would be performing two types of motion. One is the orbital motion and the second one is the spin motion. So it will have magnetic moments due to, you know, orbital motion. So we will call that magnetic dipole moment as MO, because it is occurring because of the orbital motion. Because it spins, it will have a magnetic moment due to spin. So it will be represented by MS. Okay, so just make that correction over here. Here the suffix should be S because it is appearing because of the spin of electron. So together, if I add, so you can see when we talk about these directions basically, okay, so they will depend on the direction of the revolution of electron and on the direction of the spin, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. And when I am saying direction of revolution, there can be n number of directions I have shown you in the picture right now. So when we talk about it together, okay, so before we move ahead, just make a note of it. Together we can frame an equation where, you know, the resultant magnetic dipole moment would be comprising of, you know, the magnetic moment due to the orbital motion and magnetic moment due to the spin motion. Hopefully you have noted this down, friends. So you can have a look at it. The net magnetic moment will be the vector sum of the dipole moments because of the two types of motion. So it will be because of orbital as well as spin. So you can have a, we can say that electron has a magnetic moment in a way. Now, if the resultant overall magnetic moment, you know, basically becomes zero, say, how can it become zero? Because of the motion of the different type of electrons in an atom, you know, they may nullify each other's effect. So the spin effect may be nullified, that clockwise would nullify anti-clockwise, and the, you know, different directions of the orbital motion would nullify the orbital moments also. Now if that happens, you can see if the vector sum vanishes or it is zero, then obviously there won't be any resultant magnetic moment and the material won't behave like a magnet. So we will call that material as a non-magnetic material, or you can also call it as a diamagnetic atom. In universe, most of the things are diamagnetic, okay? So very few materials, they contribute to magnetism, basically. So most of the materials are diamagnetic in universe, okay? So if you can see, the vector sum is finite and it does not vanish. Now, when can that happen? When the nullification is not complete. So there would be some effect or residue effect remaining. So in that case, the resultant magnetic dipole moment will be finite. And then we can say the atomic magnetic moment will have some value. Okay, it has some magnetic dipole, you can say. And such material, we will call it has magnetic material, and therefore we can say the cause of magnetization of matter will lie with the motion of electrons in the atom. Please make a note of it.
Sir, very
important. Yes.
Sir, can you please go back to the previous slide?
Then the magnetic field around a bar magnet or magnetic material can be imagined in this manner. Okay, the space surrounding the magnet. Okay, you can feel the magnetic effect in that space, and that is the magnetic field around the magnet. So let's have a quick recall about what we have understood regarding, you know, the origin of magnet. Yeah, let's talk about the same thing again, you know, just a quick recall. Magnetism has its origin in circulating atoms, charges in atoms, sorry. So let's talk about it. It will perform two types of motion, as I've said earlier, orbital motion as well as the spin motion, you can see. Okay, and these circulating electrons, they will behave like current carrying loop. This is what we were talking about. Each electron will have some magnetic moment on account of its circular as well as spin motion. So together, you can see, we can just think about it, you know, these magnetic moments, they will, you know, may nullify each other depending upon the directions in which the electrons of an atom are orbiting or spinning. So in that case, the resultant magnetic moment will be given by, you all know, will be given by the orbital magnetic moment plus the spin magnetic moment, the vector sum of it. And if the resultant magnetic moment exists, then in that case, you can say, you know, the material is, it has a magnetic dipole moment or atomic dipole. And you can see, we just talk about the cause of magnetization lying in the motion of electrons. This was a recall of what we have said just now. Okay, now important note out of it, okay. If the vector sum vanishes, okay, it's zero, that means the atom will have no magnetization. We will call it as non-magnetic or diamagnetic atom. If it is finite, then obviously what's going to happen is, you know, we will call that material as a magnetic material in that case. All right, so this is an important note for, you know, everybody. Okay, just a minute, friends. Yeah, so this is something which I was talking about. So based on this, you know, we are going to categorize the materials into different types basically. So please make a note of it, whatever we have recalled as of now.